preparations for a cancer therapy. The medication arrives in a box with shielding lead walls. It shouldn't be touched, it's radioactive. The doctor can observe on the screen how the radioactive substance is spreading through the organism. Its job is to destroy tumors and metastases there. In order to prevent it from destroying healthy cells too, the scientists resort to a trick. They bond the radioactive substance to molecules, which dock to certain receptors on cancer cells. This way, very targeted irradiation of the tumors is possible, while sparing healthy tissue as good as possible. This is where the new ally against cancer cells comes from, the research neutron source in Garching near Munich. A member of staff carefully packs the ampule with the starting material. Via a pneumatic tube, the ampule goes into the heart of the neutron source. It will spend several days there, being bombarded intensively with neutrons. This is just-in-time production, because the medication only is very short-lived. After only 6 days, half of it will have decayed. This is the source material, ytterbium oxide. If radiated with neutrons, ytterbium-176 turns into lutetium-177, the active substance in the cancer medication. Radiochemists at the Technische Universitaet Muenchen have found a way to isolate lutetium in medical quality from the emerging mixture. The chemical similarity of ytterbium and lutetium is challenging, but thanks to a special combination of sequestering agents and column resin, we can separate them. 6 days later, a sufficient amount of lutetium-177 has formed. The ampule needs to remain in the cooling pond for another 24 hours, because now it is highly radioactive. A thick water layer protects the operators from the radiation. On the day after, the byproducts with a shorter half-life have decomposed. Now it is a race against time, because as much of the generated lutetium as possible should make it to the patient. The ampule still possesses high activity. It may only be touched and processed with so-called manipulators behind thick protective shields of special glass. In spite of the pressure of time, all operations need to be done with great precision. One mistake and lutetium for 50 patients would be lost. The neutron source at the Technische Universitaet Muenchen is one of the few facilities worldwide that can produce such medication for radiation therapy. All steps are documented in detail. This is part of the quality assurance. A member of staff is bringing the lutetium from the research reactor. A heavy lead container blocks the radiation during transport. It is only several hundred meters to the next processing station. The destination? Isotope Technologies Garching, a company specialized on radioactive isotopes for medical purposes. Here too, medication is only handed over upon signature. Safety has highest priority. In the clean room of ITG, it gets more complicated. In addition to radiation protection, the rules of pharmacological production need to be observed. That means that everything must be disinfected before entering. This is where the method, developed by radiochemists at the Technische Universitaet Muenchen, comes in. These columns do the actual work, a special resin and an elaborately refined solvent mixture. A robot eventually fills the finished lutetium solution into flasks. At the hospital, a radiochemist receives the transport container. In the laboratory, he doses the medication. Every patient gets an individually calculated dose. There are still many promising approaches to making the therapy even more effective. There is, for instance, medication that can increase the irradiation effect in the tumor, or methods that allow more lutetium to enter the tumor. For example, when fighting against liver metastases, the medication can be injected directly into the liver artery. And while work continues in the laboratories, for the first patients, the research results of the Munich scientists mean that the diagnosis of cancer no longer needs to be a death sentence.